Welcome to day 299, make it Songbringer! Today I'm doing the playthrough. Basically just gonna play the game today. I'm finishing up updating stuff, like I've been posting updates everywhere. What's up, Hardboiled? First, totally. I got those bugs second. What's up, Azarus? I got those bugs fixed with the crafting. I'm gonna play through. I gotta spend some time testing it though, so that's what today's about. I'm gonna play through and also test the new stuff. What's up, Arcane? Marza, Pedro. Yes, it is almost day 300. Scottish Pizza. Nice, man. Cool. Oh, Pizza. While you're here, I want to let you know there's a light for Jib now. Actually, you can see it probably. Yeah. If I go to. So Jib's got his own little light. Like if you run away from him, you know, he's got his own little light at nighttime. So that's cool. Just so you know, tonight's seed is Arcane. All right, you called it, man. Today's world seed is Arcane for sure. First person to call it, Arcane gets it. Did I fix the no music in boss fights? No, I haven't fixed it. I literally spent the entire day yesterday just fixing the bug with crafting. It was a gigantic fix to the whole game because I had to change the way all items work and then I had to go test every single item. So it was a lot of work, but that's why I want to do one more test today to make sure it still works. What's up, Salad Dongs? Annals, yes. Annals? Oh, that's right. Yep. I think we're going to have to save Annals for some other time. Because Arcane called it just so swiftly. You votes for time travel? So how you guys doing today? Just posting a little update. I posted an update to the Steam page. I posted to Kickstarter. Now I got to post to... Tumblr... I'll post the IndieDB later today. What's up, Happy Moose? I'm awesome. Yo, Ferk. Yeah, I know, right? Yeah, did you know that Twitch is forcing you to put the category creative if you post in game dev? The update to the update that I'm talking about right now, that I'll be testing today, will be up tonight. So once again, the reason I'm testing it so hard is because there's so many changes to the items. So there's a lot of that. To like upload and stuff. I guess I can just fix. I can do this later, huh? Posting in Tumblr. Yeah, I'll finish this later. I'm already getting tired of this. All right, let's. Oh. Yeah. So now that Jib has a light, I want to put a light item in the world, really quick. So when it's placing items. In the stores. So cactus there and jib light here. So the jib light's cool because it's upgradable. When you get one jib light, or actually you'll start with one jib light already. So let's test this all out actually. With jib, his lights start at zero, but that gives him a little bit of light. Why creative and not game development? It doesn't allow you to anymore. Yeah, there was a post yesterday we found on Reddit, and basically Twitch is forcing everyone to start using the creative category because it's actually kind of cool because you can put hashtags with your creative category, and then if you're creating stuff and you're making pixel art, you can hashtag pixel art. If you're doing programming like I do a lot. or game dev. You can use game dev programming, you know, all these kinds of hashtags, and then people can find you better. And apparently they're going to highlight people on the creative categories too. Does your ECS manage the rooms? No, that's a good question, Happy Moose. If every room was an entity, then every I guess I could do it. Oh man, I just thought of how I wouldn't have to do it. So anyways, the current ECS only manages entities within the rooms. The rooms themselves are not actual entities because I didn't want to use up any more entity IDs. Because on certain screens, there can be like tons of entities already. Right? It'd be better if you could filter multiple tags. Yeah. So, right? Like on this screen right here, there's a lot of entities because, I mean, even just these mountains have a couple entities for each one of these tiles. So I just didn't want to throw a whole bunch more entities in because right now there's so many areas that are always loaded in memory, their actual data. But I just realized that I could actually create an area entity for an area component for each area that's only been created. So you would at maximum have two of them open. That would actually work. Been thinking about doing that. That's actually a good idea, Happy Moose. I might change that. So I want the jib light to have a light even if you don't have this item at all. So the strength of his light is going to be something like 0.07F plus the number of lights you have times 0.07 and then clamp that to 0.21. And then constants.cpp, make sure that you can have up to two of those lights, but it's not depletable, so you're not gonna get the maximum item when you buy it. So let's, I wanna test this out. Now he should have a smaller light, but he should still have a light, right? So he has zero lights, but he should still have a light anyways. And then he'll have a upgrade technically with quantity one, and then an even further upgrade with quantity two. So yeah, there's a really tiny light. That's the smallest Jib's light will ever be. Let's see this whole day-night situation going faster. Let's upgrade his light now. Let's see what light looks like at one. Now we need light flicker in spooky places. Yes. Yeah, yeah. It's already in there. I already got the code for flickering. I just got it turned on. Okay, so there's one upgrade to his light. What's up, PETA? Second attempt. Bellazio. Marsa. What's up? Oh, you're calling him second attempt? Okay, good. Now, let's see it upgraded even further. Oh, and I gotta turn down my FPS. No, what's up, man? What's up, Kix? Yeah, I want to see it one more time. So that's his light, sort of bigger. That's two upgrades. I think it should be a little bigger than that. So let's put the maximum of this at 0.3, and each one is like 11 per. I miss you guys. I miss your banter. Yeah, that's good enough. Maybe a little more. So 0.13 times 2 is going to be 0.26 plus 0.07 is 0.33-ish. Let's pick this 0.4, the biggest you can get. All right, so you can now buy lights. And I need to do an item really quick. You streamed Songbringer earlier? Nice. Your friend's three-year-old loved it? Sweet. Oh, right on. Okay, HUD. All right, I need to just do a light item. Ah, you know what? Screw it. We don't need this to play through today. Let me test the to make sure we can buy it though in the dungeon or in the store. Would be, I think 201 would be the store we want here. ECS question 2. Are sprites entities components? No, they're not. I'm thinking I'll make sprites in ECS and have them look up on a map of actual texture bounding box. Nice. No, I just use regular sprites. And I have render components to technically own sprites. So I guess so. Yeah, I guess I kind of do. I'm basically composing a render component, right? My render component has a sprite in it and a pointer to a label and a bunch of other stuff it uses to render. So kind of it's a mix of using Coco's 2DX's sprite and a render component. You can only pay in girls or pizza. Or girls on pizza? Sounds exciting. So something happened there. It didn't have the item for sale. Oh, because I've already got it. I've already bought that item, technically. So if I go back to zero, I should be able to buy this jib light. Yeah, totally. Of course. Is it supposed to be level 3? What's that? What you mean? Mm. Oh, it looks like it didn't have an item frame for it. So item jib, oh, it's because item jib light's empty right now. You can have two of these, yeah. The cup dungeon. Yeah, it's technically only level 3 right now, and that will be randomized at some point, right? There will be 3 different cup dungeons, and they'll be a totally different style. They're not as much of the regular kind of dungeon. Okay, now it just needs some text. There, so now you can, now I'll have some text to purchase it. Oh, I don't have 75. Nice. All right. Technically, you can now purchase the jib light upgrade. I'm not sure if it will actually increase his jib light right there, but we'll see. Yeah, you couldn't get access to level three. It's so weird. Let me play through that really quick on this dungeon. If I could fix the entrance really quick before I do the playthrough. I guess we got to get to level 3 first. It's up in the middle of this world. this is that bug store.
Oh, damn it.
Yeah, that's when you first get the sword, you fight the first guy. Oh, now isn't it? Where's level 3? Oh, it's maybe up there. Ah, oh, here it is. Test this out. So you were not able to access it at all? Oh, it put doors all of a sudden. Oh, these are not supposed to have doors here. Okay, quick ways to fix this. Oh man, this means I gotta test stuff though. World. I'm golden, where's my alpha? Did you just purchase? Humble's take. I'm not sure if I'm at liberty to actually say that on the live stream. I don't know. I don't know if that's confidential or not. They made me sign stuff, and I can't remember. Did you? Oh man, I can't send you the alpha right now because I'm live streaming, and then I'll show all the codes, all the Steam codes if I open them up right now. But yeah, Happy Moose, I have to manually reply to every one of those. One of those emails. Bug of the quick launch bar. What's that? Alex Pita, did you try full screen mode? If you have any kind of issues with your window settings, just go to your saves and go full screen. I mean, the entrance was from the top of the screen. I wasn't gonna be able to get to the well to drink from it. Oh, well, there's also doors. There's not even supposed to be doors. Okay, quick solution to fix this right now would be, let me turn off the game hour really quick, this fast game hour. And if I go to area creation, this is not proper, but I should do this the proper way. Damn it. Entities, door, all right, this is going to be now door one and two, both have renders. And when we're looking up doors, area creation, create door. It's gonna look up get any data for we can just do, yeah. Kit, string with format, boss door, percent D, no, it's gotta be percent C, boss door, which means entities needs to be this way around. All this is gonna be percent Bostor with world get style car for this z area pause dot z. There, that's the proper way. It's good to do things right. What's wrong with this though? Oh, just one more parenthesis. There we go. Okay, and then the same thing for the regular door. This thing is loaded just like this door, but with the style code. There. So now Dungeon 3 should not have any doors anymore. Just kidding about where's my alpha? Nice. Oh, sorry, man. I wish I could give it to you right now. You can see full. Are you sure? Alex Peter, are you double sure that you're in full screen mode like this? Because there's a big difference between that and this. There's two kinds of full screen. One is like this, where you it might be possible for you to see the bottom quick launch bar, but this it should be guaranteed to be full screen. Oh. Okay, let's see if that works. Sorry guys, I'm such a spaz today. I need a break. I've been doing bugs for too long. I've been lost in bug land. Okay, there. Now the doors are gone. What's this? Can we get keys still? Oh, there's the boss. Okay, yeah, so this would have been a boss door right here. Okay, so this dungeon should now be completable and playable once again. In the blink orb here. At least in this world. And then it should warp you. Yeah, it warps me back right back there. Okay, that was good. But now I need to test to make sure level 1 still has doors. Yep, speed fixes. Okay, very good. Still have doors. And they have keys and everything. Okay. Let's make sure dungeon 2 has doors. Oh, is that who had the other accounts yesterday? Yeah, the game was ridiculous, or the stream was ridiculous yesterday. So funny. Alright, cool. Let me test this. So I sit at the boss door for level 2. But I open up the switch. So this is going to be 2, 4. Say I've activated that switch. All right, almost ready to do this playthrough. Oh, Wizard Pool. Never know who's Wizard Food. Wizard Food. Who was that? All right, good. We're all ready to play now. Let's do this. Wait, let me make sure. Hold on. I don't have any other crazy code in here that might change the way this playthrough. I don't want it to break. That just changes his light position. That gives him the light. That fixes the doors for dungeon 3. This adds, I'm adding items like the poison blink. I'm not sure if you'll be able to use them just yet. This is an upgrade to light components so they can have an offset. Yeah, all this looks good. Okay. We're ready to do this. Right, XPixel? Yeah, that's just because I pre-build as much as possible. So I have all these static libraries ready to go. Okay, let's do this. We'll turn off skip menu so we can see from the very beginning. Hell, let's play from the very, very beginning. Actually, I'll back up my saves file. Wait. I'm gonna copy my saves file to current. And I'm also gonna put it in a note here. And I'm just gonna delete everything, start over, even bindings. Ready to do this? Butter! Where can we modify the settings file in Windows? Yeah, you just saves that text. Thanks, Pedro. I know, we already got a world code though. Arcane called it. Arcane's called the name Arcane so many times, so gotta honor him in his Arcane world seed. So today's world seed shall be Arcane, but Butter is a cool name. Also, Annals was a fun name that's going to be tried at some point. All right, yeah, so here we go. Playing with my Xbox controller. So yeah, what you guys see on Steam is a little bit... So Steam is what I uploaded yesterday, but today I made fixes and... I uploaded 2 days ago. Yeah, I spent an entire day yesterday fixing bugs with the crafting system. So this playthrough, I'm gonna be testing the crafting system and then uploading again to Steam tonight. So the update will be updated tonight. Yeah, Marza, that's gonna be an option. So it's eventually gonna be an option in the option screen. I know it doesn't seem intuitive. That's just because it's the text file right now and I haven't hooked it up to the settings menu. So it'll get better. Thank you, backers. Yeah, Alex Pita, it is. So it's now full screen by default. All right, today's world seed. Arcane. Let's hope it's a good one. Your seed was cheese? Okay, so why couldn't you access it? Was it that you had, were you blocked by something? What was causing you to not be able to access it? The trees were blocking you. Oh, weird. Okay, well, we gotta note this one. Oh, I can't alt tab out right now. Alright, let me get Trello open on my phone so I can note some bugs. There won't be any left. Alright, new bug. Can't get to cup fountain because trees are blocking world seed cheese. Oh, I almost got it though. Thanks though. Okay, got it. All right. Bot Patrol, what's that? Happy Musa, how many is that? I think it's twice that. I think you're missing one letter. Six letters. Six to the 26th power. Jupiter, this is, I'm running it on Mac right now. It runs on Windows and Mac, and it's eventually going to run on Linux too, by the beta version. So beta version, it'll be Linux. When it's released, it'll definitely be on iOS as well, and possibly other platforms. That announcement will come later. Windows 1.0. Yes, the seed is arcane. DOS 6.22. No, Happy Moose, that's not true. Each time, each letter can still be 26. You can do the world seed A. Or B. You know? What is this ViewBot thing? Never seen it before. No, Jim! Don't get hurt! Don't hurt my Jim! I kinda like his light. I think maybe his light should turn off though if there's enough light already around. Maybe it should flicker when it turns on too. That'd be kinda cool. BBB, yeah, great game. A DOS port? Mesa 3D? I've never heard of that. Yeah. Well, if you can note that too on the Trello, that would be awesome. Just to make it so levels are always at least, you know, a few screens away from each other. I think I'm gonna go straight up this time. Yeah. Yay. ColecoVision. Yeah. Yeah, as long as that's a reality, I hope that it is. Oh, check it out, this level's got a store. Oh, okay, let's test this out. I've always wondered. Yeah, you can't go inside stores if you're fighting a boss. And I should not be able to go in this store until I pick up the top hat. Oh, very good, very good. Okay. That was good. What engine did you use? It's called Cocos 2DX. Mesa 3D, that's cool. Wow, that's really impressive, yeah. What's the Vectrex? I can't afford any of these items yet, but I'm getting close. I already got 24. Yeah, no, Cocos 2D is Objective-C. Cocos 2DX is a C++ cross-platform game engine. I can write all my code in C++, and then I get to export it to whatever platform. Windows, Mac, Linux, iOS, Android. Well, the only problem with all those is that you have to test it like crazy for each one of those platforms, so it's difficult for a single developer to support all those, even though I can easily compile. That was lucky. Stepped on that guy. Forgot I had the top hat. So Jib's light is really weak. I think maybe it should be a little bigger by default. I wanted it to be nice and big at night even. Or maybe it's just because he's a little farther away. Oh yeah, it does get a little bigger when he gets closer. The Flux thing? No, that, well, are you talking about the code Flux, or the app I use called Flux? The app I use called Flux is a great thing that turns down the screen. brightness at night. So it's not really has anything to do with game development, really. Other than just keeping my eyes nice. But the flux thing is just something, a custom piece of code I wrote in the game, which is just a transition. So I could have called it transition, it would be the same thing. The Vectrex is a technological miracle. What is it? Oh, I went totally the wrong way for level one. So I think I've got to continue that way, because if I go this way, I might not be going. Yeah. I got both those. The app and that. Ooh, getting lost here. Totally getting lost. It's an old game console, 100% Vector? Wow. Alright. Tempest, sure. Trying to think of other Vector games from the 70s. Ah, I missed the diamond! Wait a minute, did I just hit Jib? There's no way I just hit Jib. What? Bashed it for fun? Yeah, Jupiter, this game is very inspired by Sword and Sorcery, Crawl, Hyperlight Drifter, Super Metroid, Crystallis for the NES, of course, The Legend of Zelda. But yeah, the art style has really been influenced by a lot of the modern day beautiful pixel art games that I just mentioned. What else? Children of Morta. They're a great inspiration. Anton Kudin's Megasphere. Aider. Of course, Aider's, you know, an amazing looking game. Pixel art. Oh, another store. I only got 30, though. Damn. Can't buy anything. I would actually buy that now. That's cool. That's one good reason to. Oh, let's buy some. Should I buy some cactuses? Why not? Big spender. Yeah. I got a cactus now. Don't tell me this is one of those worlds where it's really hard to get to level one. This is far away. Either that, it's just a convoluted path that I don't know how to get to. Yeah, this is not easy. Unless I missed something there? Did I miss something? Wait. Yeah, there's a. Didn't I just go this way? Yeah. Oh, I can go this way. That just looks like it's not accessible. Ah, oh, damn, that's right. Bugs. Too many bugs. Way too many. It's the days where you spend an entire day working on one bug, and you spend the whole day and you don't even finish that bug. Those are the kind of days that can be demoralizing. Just like yesterday. Ah, that's right. Oh, so here's the problem, I think, on this screen. Is that there's water right here, which is blocking this path. There. So I'll save a screenshot of that, because that's what might be the bug right here in this world. Alright. Fuck that. I'm not even gonna go to level one. Go around. What's up, Silly Billy Bear? I'm okay, man. I'm burnt out, actually. I need a break. But yeah, just doing a playthrough here. I got another update to release tonight to the update. No, I do not have an iOS test flight. Probably won't be one, to tell you straight. There probably will not be an iOS test flight, but there will be a beta version of the Windows, Mac, and Linux. And you can play that, you can order it at pre-order, songbringer.com/pre-order. So, thanks, Silly Billy Bear. Well, good thing we played this world, found yet another bug. With how the world is generated. So it generates, you know, it's a procedurally generated game. So each one of these updates and stuff like that, it gets a little bit better. Each update, something else is improved. Here's another, okay. Can't get there either. I'm looking for level 2, maybe. I think you can't even access level 1 on this world. Let's save here. Yes. It's not technically a lightsaber, it's a vibrating sword. It's like a vibrating nano sword. Blame Arcane? It's not your fault, Arcane! It's the code's fault. So if I could find level 2, that would be awesome. Yeah, right? Thanks for being there the whole time. All the way since the early days. Over a year ago. This game's been in development for a while. Alright, I'm thinking maybe up. It usually does not take this long to find level 1. I'm 16 minutes in already. I mean, I don't think I can get to level 1 in this world. That's a bug. Did I do any work on crawl? No. Oh, is this what you were talking about? Okay, I see what you're saying, Hard-Boiled Egg. So it just, for some reason, it put like a crazy amount of trees on this screen. And you can't even access the dungeon, so. Take another screenshot there. There's bug number 2. Yeah, crawl's a big influence. Ashi-chan? Yeah, crawl's a big influence. I was just mentioning influences a second ago. Swords and Sorcery's a big influence. Crawl's a great influence. They're an amazing team. I really respect those guys. Axiom Verge is an influence. Oops, I ate one of my cactuses. Let's map that to Y. all the pixel art games of late that have been really great. Ader's a big influence, you know. All these amazing pixel art games that have been released in the late Linus. Oh, that was cool. It's always these bug worlds like this where you find a world where there's some problem in the maze generator. Like this world, the problem in the maze generator is that it placed level one just behind this water. It drew some water on this one screen which blocked access to level one. So it's not really the maze generator as much as the actual area generator which draws the current area. Or not draws the current area, but decides what tiles should be put on a certain area. So this game is procedurally generated all the way down to just the tile level. And on that particular screen, the tiles it chose blocked it. No, wait, this way is blocked too? I just explored this whole section. Oh, man. We might have to start over a whole new world. This might be the most buggy world ever. So I just explored all that. It looks like I could go this way though. Tell me there's something cool over here. Dude, another refill. No, just Happy Moose. As a pixel artist, you should have a look at Under Rail. Cool. I would do that right now, but right in the middle of this playthrough. But Under Rail, yeah, I'll try and remember that. Normally, what I do is I save links to the desktop, but I'm in full screen mode right now in this game, so I can't alt tab out. That's why I've always had the default to be. Wait, can I alt tab out? I can't. I think I changed it to full screen mode. What? I'm so hoping for a level. What's up, Scottish Pizza? It is, yes. Yes, I'm very thankful. This is an amazingly good bug to find. Ah, damn. Yeah, hard-boiled egg, you can do whatever. Do you have a PlayStation controller? Because if you have a PlayStation controller, all your graphics for your buttons turn into PlayStation buttons, and technically you can map them however you want. So, yeah, it's technically already has PlayStation controller support. Unless you mean something else? Are you talking about something else? That's also a bug. There shouldn't be those, there's like this gap right there underneath those pillars. Really doesn't need that. Please, I just want to find level two. Whoa, what was that noise? Manic! Hey, what's up, Manic? Thanks, man. Thanks for hosting. Thank you. my god! There's a bug right here so I can get to this world. I'm taking it. I should take a screenshot of that bug, though. Yes, arcade! Level 7! Oh, this is gonna be tough. This is the most buggy world I've ever played recently. Oh shit, now it took away the... whatever. You're using a program that emulates a 360 controller. Oh no, yeah, you don't need that. You've been doing your first dev stream? Nice, man. Yeah. I remember you telling me about these, and like I said, the last 2 days I've been working on a single bug fix for the crafting system, so that's why I haven't really gotten to anything else on the Trello board. It sucks when you spend a whole day and you don't even finish one thing. It's like, that's why I'm so kind of burnt out today. And I still have more testing work to do to make sure that everything's still working with that, but let's hope it works, since this live stream will actually show whether it does, I guess. What's buggy? Yeah, basically everything. Well, what's buggy is that it put too much water or something. For some reason I couldn't get to level 1. And then every other level basically is inaccessible to you because you can't get bombs until you've been to level 1 or 2. So I was looking for level 2 forever and I couldn't find level 2. Finally, I found level 7. So I'm playing level 7 now and hopefully I can, you know, get through this dungeon. I don't know if I can with level 1 items. Let's see. I got some cactuses that could help. But it's not your fault, Arcane. It's the code. And it's actually a really good thing to find this, because I can fix this in a jiffy. Okay, so I opened up this door. The game doesn't recognize your PS4 controller? At all? This doesn't even work? That sucks. I thought it, I don't know why I wouldn't. I guess I gotta buy a PS4 controller. No, Hardboiled, you gotta go, once you've plugged in your new controller, you just gotta go to settings, and then click add bindings, and then your PS4 controller should work. You just bind some new things, and it'll keep your old bindings too, so you can plug in your Xbox 360 controller or whatever. I guess that's a bug too, it shouldn't. I'll note this bug really quick. When using fine. Alright. Cool. Got that bug noted too. How do you figure out the proper pixel dimension for sprites? You gotta decide your ratio first. Decide your ratio, decide your overall dimension of your game, first of all. You know? Yeah, you can already use your default controls, your keyboard, to bind those keys. Yeah, Zen Soturi, this game does that too. I'm just giving him instructions on how to get it to bind the keys once it has already recognized it. Doesn't matter what controller you put in, it should recognize it. Doesn't matter what platform either. For this game, I mean. I've already been this way, haven't I? Managed to bind the PS4 buttons with the keyboard, but the button layout is still the Xbox 360 one. What? No, I mean, you should be able to go to your settings and then use the keyboard to get to the add bindings thing. And then once you're at the add bindings thing, you just use your PS4 only. Button layout is still the X360 one? It sounds like it didn't actually bind the PS4 buttons. I don't know. That's what you did? Really? Huh. Maybe the PS4 and the Xbox have the exact same amount of buttons or something. If you could, it'd be so cool to see your binding, your saves text with your bindings right now. So like if you go to your saves.txt and then there's this one bit of your saves.txt which has the bindings, and if you copy and paste that onto the Trello, it'd be sweet to see that, because I'm thinking it might have bound, this PS4 might be the exact same number of buttons and axes and everything as the Xbox 360, so maybe it's generating or the wrong code or something like that. It does have more buttons? Huh. What the heck happened there? Got a key. Sweet. Whoa. It'd be cool if your top hat could trigger these. Which door is it gonna be? Door number one? Door number two? Yeah, more cactuses. Yeah, I use there's a library called OIS. It's, what does it stand for? I don't know, it's on SourceForge. It's just OIS. It's a cross-platform controller library. Cactus. Just got hit right when I ate the cactus right there. Well, the menu double taps the direction, but not in the game, as in I press once up and it thinks I pressed twice. Huh. I really want to see your bindings in your saves.txt. That would really help me to figure out what the heck is happening there. Eh. What's up, Boogie? Playing another buggy worlds here. Luckily, we found this bug though. This is a huge bug. There's another level 1 issue where I couldn't get to level 1, so I'm once again playing the game at a really high level of difficulty. This is level 7 with only level 1 items. It's the alpha version. Lots of bugs. Cactuses. Alright, I'm back to this part of the dungeon. The very beginning. Going south. What's here? Oh, dang, some friendly bats. These bats are be my friends. Oh. Bombs! It's about time! Had I gone straight down from the very beginning with my first key, I would have had a much easier route through this dungeon. What's this? There's nothing here. It's a completely blank room. This is curious. What is this? Take a screenshot. What's the screenshot? There. Can you show me how you swap items? Yeah, please, yeah, just copy and paste the text for your bindings to the Trello, please, thank you. Yes, how you swap items, you just go to your inventory, press select to go to your inventory, and then you just press whatever key you want to be the new item button. So if I want to map Y to the top hat, I just press Y. If I want to press B for the buttons, no problem. But I want my top hat to be X, my bombs to be B. I'm just getting my ass kicked. Oh no. What scene should you do? I don't know, what do you want to- Oh, I'm playing the debug version. Put me back in the same room. Also, first of all, let's take off the default of using full screen. Gonna change that. Let's compile in release mode, so I'm playing the build that you guys will play. It's the seat of champions. Yeah, nobody try this seed until I fix it. Tonight. Alright, it's gotta compile, but I'm running in release mode, so I get to actually play the hard way for this level. Maybe I should do a different world seed, huh? Yeah, it's just one of those days. One of those days. Annals. All right. Yeah, I'm gonna do a different world scene. This one was really demoralizing me, but I shall fix the bug. Thank you, Arcane. Thanks for a really good bug to find. I'm sure it's something simple. Anacra, the backwards. We're gonna go with Annals this time. Cause that was confirmed, we gotta play that one. Not Arcane backwards for sure. Well, we already confirmed we're gonna do Annals. What's up, State Off? Howdy howdy, thanks for your suggestions again, by the way. I haven't put those on the Trello yet because I was working on this bug, this crafting bug yesterday. Toilet's a good seed? That it may be. So, yeah, what I'm working on here is this playthrough, because I'm kind of testing out the new item system. The items have all, the whole way the systems work is for items is all changed. So that's why I really need to do this playthrough test. But so far, the items have been working perfectly fine, but I haven't tried the crafting yet, of course. So that will be kind of the determinant. So if I can get through this world, beat the first level, get the teleport cube. Wait a minute, why is it asking for... Damn it. Don't tell me it lost my whole world. What happened? Oh, because I switched to release mode. Damn it. Oh well. I'll start completely over then. Do over! Mulligan! Mulligan, we're doing World Seed Annals. World Seed Annals. Cool name. At last! I know. It takes too long to... Bought for the seed randomizer. No way, was that really his random... Did he come up with that? What's that black bar on top? Pedros! Oh, Bafu didn't come up with that? That's a cool idea, though. Would he take, like, actual words? Like, would he use two-letter words, three-letter words, four-letter words, up to six-letter words? Just, like, coming up with random stuff? Or would he just come up with random letters? A diamond! I'm in the habit of always checking these surroundings of the first sword cave thing here. Make sure everything's looking good. Oh, everyone tells him and then he chooses the best one. Oh, that's cool. So everybody votes. Like, there's a command where you can vote for Bafu's the seed, and then he chooses one. That's cool. That would be sweet. It's almost like Twitch plays. Alright, we're doing a totally different world seed, starting over here. Which way should I go? Left? Up? Yeah, totally have no control over that at all. Alright, I went left up-ish last time, so maybe I'll go right this time. Unless you guys have a preference. You don't want to shout out where I should walk to. Because this could change the whole run here, which way I go from the beginning. Past that. It would never end. Wow. tentacles, mentacles. Yay, it did have a reward. I said this instinct, like this screen, it's gotta have a reward. Look, I can get past there. Take a screenshot. I thought I'd fix those. No, I have not updated the update yet. I worked all day yesterday. Did not finish the one bug I was working on. I was working on crafting all yesterday. So I'm testing it right now, actually. This run will be a test on whether crafting system works. This guy's a little aggressive. It's a very aggressive blob. I mean, I'd be aggressive too if I was just an orange blob. Where the hell is this? Oh, right! It was just right there. Yay. Yeah, so it's gonna be tonight. I'm pretty sure the crafting is all fixed up now. And... ooh, I don't have enough to buy anything, but what's in this store? What is he made of? Jello? Gelatinous substances, light upgrade. I think I'm gonna buy the cactus because that turned out to be clutch last game. Jello booger. Jello booger. Jello boogers. You can totally understand why he's aggressive. With a name like that. I just walked all the way around. I'm not having very good luck today with where to walk. I think these mazes are a little bit too difficult. They're pissing me off. The second world in a row with too difficult of a maze. Gotta lighten this up. Scanner drone only searches out the first dungeon no matter what, right? Currently, yes. The design for later is that you'll be able to get multiple scanner drones for the world. Actually, one scanner drones will scan out the first three levels, so they'll go and they'll give you a red dot for level 1, and then after you beat level 1, you'll have a red dot for level 2, and then a red dot for level 3. And then you're going to be able to find two more copies of the scanner drones for the overworld that will show you where levels 4 through 6 and 7 through 9 are. What if you could save it? It'll always searches out the next company. Yes, exactly. That's what, yeah. That's one of the, it's already on the Trello. I've been meaning to do that. It's just... another one of those things that there's higher priority bugs to fix. Yeah. What's the reason for scanner drones being in inventory? So you could use them. It's like a reward. They're not in my inventory anymore. But the point is that you feel rewarded as a player when you use something. So instead of just automatically using them. Yeah, I know, but that's not as fun. It's just not as fun for the it's not as rewarding for the player to pick something up and it's automatically used. This is really the core of this game is a feeling of exploration and adventure mixed with action. So that's the thing. When you in an adventure-y kind of game, getting rewarded for doing little things and figuring things out is always a good thing. I've got school in 4 hours of judo. What? Whoa! Judo chop! Alright, Scottish pizza. See you, man. Bombs. This level's nice. I like this level. It's been very nice to me. It's playing nice today. Except for this. Oh, man. That's tough. What are you supposed to do? Trapped between... Oh, dude, so trapped right now. Oh, no way to get past that. Wait, you can go like this. Oh, yes. Oh, damn it. Mini games of Sokoban? What's that? What's Sokoban? Pulverizer should take like 3 health. Man. If they took 3 health, I would be dead so often. And isn't the developer supposed to be the best person at the game? I'm definitely not the best person at this game. I'm having a tough time. Either that or the game is just too hard right now. I don't know. Yay! Solve a puzzle? Yeah, there'll be puzzles. There'll be actual puzzles. Keep in mind, this is the alpha version of the game. There's a lot to be added. I want bombs to be B. Scanner drones Y for now. Let's eat a cactus. I do not know Sokoban. What's that? But only on permadeath? Hugspeed has words. Oh, if I save scanner drones I get from a dungeon, they disappear from my inventory once I'm out of it. I can't use them in the next dungeon. Yeah, that's by design. That's by design. You're not meant to... The scanner drones are meant to be used only in the current dungeon. But maybe that should change. Maybe I should make it so scanner drones, you can use... If you find them in a dungeon, you could use them on the overworld. That's certainly a possibility. I'm open to that. What do you guys think? Should scanner drones be usable elsewhere? Like if you find a... Scanner drones in level 1, can you go to the overworld and use them there? Or instead of using them in level 1, you can use them in level 3? Something like that? It might be fun to do that, actually. I mean, scanner drones and the bio drone things are really... They're not super... important items, you know, like they just show you where stuff is, so I guess it would be okay completely to allow that. So long as they're definitely gonna be one use, totally. I know, yeah, that's one problem with them recently, is that they are only usable Or they usually show up towards the end of the dungeon, which is, you know, it shouldn't be like that. Oh my god. Ooh, let's definitely eat a cactus right now. Good thing I bought the cactuses! It's making this room really easy. Yeah, I got this. Switch room number one, no problem. Yeah, it's definitely showed up too late. Oh, you felt like that in Zelda games, huh? Oh, good point, Mars. That's a good point. So maybe limit how many the player can have at once so the player can't stockpile them? But then if they find it in a dungeon and they would not be able to get it, I guess they could just get it at them again or something. Maybe give the player a reward for not using them. But even with one, you can save the first one you find for later. Yeah. Sell them at the pawn shop. Or just one of each? I mean, would it really be that bad for the player to save a map and use it later? I guess it kind of would be a great advantage for them. And if the player was wise enough to do that, you know, why not allow them to do that? Got you! Full health too, nice. That's the nice thing about switch rooms, is they do offer a lot of health, usually in the form of killing enemies. Whoops. Yeah, let's do this! Open up those doors. Should I eat a cactus right now? Probably, yeah. Yeah, I haven't fought one of these guys in a minute. Maybe the top hat shouldn't knock people back, huh? Right now we're getting the top hat shouldn't knock back foes as much as the sword does. Because it is just a little top hat, right? Maybe make them rare in later dungeons so the player would think about saving them. Huh. It's a Jell-O, it's a big Jell-O burger! Making good use of cactuses this time. Because they give you one health. Yeah, it does look kind of weird when it, right? Oh, good. Mm-hmm. hatch gets stuck inside the jello booger. I think that's a good thing to maybe at least make it so it doesn't knock back. Yeah, you know, don't knock him back as far with the top hat. Right? So, what's your preference? Should the little guys be part of the boss fight? You mean the little guys at the very end there? Oh, and then you can get it unstuck after a while? It's a cool idea, but it would require changing. I love the idea. Alright, let's see if this crafting works. Do we have anything to craft yet? I can go buy something. Let's go buy something. Oh, there's a store right up there too. I think it had a one of the elements in it. We're only got 45 though. What? I did not get that many diamonds yet. You know what? Let's go to the unexplored parts of this dungeon and see if I can find some diamonds. So I really want to buy something and craft an item. Okay, that's confirmed. You can actually go through doors that you have not been through after you defeat the boss. Come on, item. Damn. Uh-oh. Kill the nest? Does that work? That's a great question. I don't know if that works or not. I think there's supposed to be some kind of cap on that. I think the code will cap out the number of items that it puts based on spawned enemies only, though. Like spiders. Yes, stayed off. Exactly. That's what I'm talking about. Yeah, that's what I was working on yesterday. Fixing everything related to crafting. So all I need is like 100 or so to buy an element. Man, there's like no rewards in this dungeon. Was there? I think there was one, but it wasn't these rooms. Where was it that I found the original bonus thing? Yeah, it's this way. Playthroughs, I've gotten like 100 or 150 coin or diamonds even by the time I finished the first level. I usually come out of the first level with enough bucks to go get an element, but not this time. there one here? Easter egg seed, Easter. All grass, no trees. But tons of diamonds. Yeah! That's a sweet idea. So easy to do, too. No dungeons. Come on, there's gotta be some kind of reward item somewhere. Or bombable secret. I could get a bunch of diamonds at once. Store. What's this store have? Oh, don't spend your money. Don't spend it there. We need an element. Just one screen, no sword, nothing. Yeah, in the current build, it's all messed up. As soon as you craft something, it messes the item up completely. I bet you this one has an item. It really looks like one of those kind of screens. You should implement a pony you can dash around with. There's actually going to be boots items. In fact, I was going to put that in today. And then I had to do other stuff. Yes! See, more of that. That's what we need. Okay, this screen's got it right here. I could go back in the dungeon. What is this screen again? Two left of that store. So we get his bike fixed and then go to like other areas faster. What's up, Beetle J? Unreal, what's up, man? Happy New Year. It's going good, man. How you doing? Come on. Give me a reward. Oh, nothing. Oh, damn it. That was one. What's really cool about this is that the player advances by real skill, not so much by virtual skills. Old school, totally. How many people is working on the game? Just one, man. Just me. Just a little me. Cheesy. The characters tell all the cheesy jokes you can think of, and it's glorious. Yes! There's another one right here. Two away from the home screen. Just mining the world right now, looking for just a couple more coins. I can get past this. Been busy? Sweet. Last year at uni, several personal projects going on. Got some people asking me to expand on the procedural ability. Sweet. Awesome, man. How's that going? How's your, what were you working on? Was it, it was based on those cool articles you sent, right? About generating terrain. There's a couple. Yes. I'll take them. Okay, we got 90 now. It might be enough to buy some. No, I think the fear was like in that last one, and that was on like 120. We need like 30 more diamonds. Dude, this is a lot of work finding diamonds when you don't know where any secrets are. But maybe there's some secrets right here on the screen. Speak of the devil. Oh, yes! Oh, so lucky! I don't have any bombs. What a predicament. Oh, if only I had bombs. It's so lame. Dude, give me some bombs. Includes agent values. The model buildings where the certain areas are accessible by agents of different size. Oh, sweet. Cool, man. UUDDLR, I got it. I see what you're saying. What's the secret to finding secrets? Cactuses. It's mescaline. Rock should get into a berserker mode after Jib has dealt so much damage. Ooh, that's kind of a cool idea. Write notes on map? Oh, that would be cool. Let's see. Put notes on map. Set colored flags, at least. Cool idea. I knew to use it. There was no secret there. I just got really lucky by using it right there. I guess the only thing I know about the code is that it puts secrets on rock walls. So I noticed that screen had a rock wall and I was like, maybe there's a secret right there. What's up, Super Positive? You're really upset? Oh, I'm sorry, man. Once again, we can walk right by these. Oh, I just need a few more diamonds, come on. Or bombs. Bombs, like, almost never find bombs on the overworld from just killing random enemies. Almost never find them. You know what, there might be some kind of bug with that. It's like impossible to find more bombs. Either that or the probabilities is so low. Yeah, I'm writing that down, because this is like a clutch moment. If I could just get some more bombs, I could go to that. That. Yeah, no, it's truly random. I don't know where there's gonna be secrets. And there's gonna be more kinds of secrets eventually. So right now, it only has, like, you know, secrets in the rocks. But eventually there'll be secrets everywhere. In water, trees. Oh, so you found a bomb, yeah? But they're rare? Yeah, they're too rare. They're way too rare. It must be the probability is just too low. When this game is released, you can bet your butt I'm gonna be one of the first ones to review it. Sweet, man. Several teleport cubes, or just one extra, you can buy it. Oh, for faster travel? Yeah, that was the original idea, was to have multiple teleport cubes. That's a great idea to finish that up. Concept. So you would be able to warp to different areas. This might be a secret area. It might have some. I mean, this might have a reward item here. Yeah, faster travel, huh? Or how about a secret cave? Or a cave, just a cave, that you go inside of it, and then you come back out, and you're in a different place. Where'd that guy go? Jump right on Chip. Oh, there's no item. Damn. Do you ever do any 3D game dev? No, I do not. Log Papa Bear. I prefer my 2D games, man. I'm not really a fan of 3D games as much these days. I've always been, I guess because I'm old. I'm 36 years old, you know, so I grew up playing 2D games. And I guess I have some nostalgia for them. But also, I prefer 2D gameplay. I like to play games with only 2D because, I guess because our screens are 2D these days still. I don't know, there's something more natural to me about pixel art and 2D games, so that's why I prefer to make them and make them only. Save point could be a teleport, like when you teleport onto Songbringer. Or just to any teleport. Did I play Secret of Mana? Yes, hell yes. Secret of Mana and Mystic Quest, the precursor to the Secret of Mana series. Mystic Quest actually is one of definitely an influence on this game. So of course it's Secret of Mana. You can definitely see the Secret of Mana. But Secret of Mana itself was inspired by Legend of Zelda, so. Uphill battle finding diamonds. Or bombs. Shit, I would take either of those. You prefer 2D games too? Alright, so it's not just me. Yeah, yeah. You could take over your trailing character. Yeah, I remember. This game is actually, you're gonna have local co-op. So a person can plug in a second controller and play as Jib, the little robot. And I'm thinking there might be a dungeon eventually where, where you get to play as Jib because you get knocked out or something like that, or you get thrown in jail, something like that, where you're basically disabled and you have to play as Jib. Damn, this guy is just elusive, Frere. Won't allow me to. Oh, wait, I can get around the bottom. It's hard to see at night. No secret item! Get some cactuses there. Yeah, so I'm definitely gonna increase the probability of finding bombs. That would be clutch right now. Oh, Unreal, cool idea. I just finally read that. A poster idea with the top hat returning. It's a cool idea. I like that. I started this one poster idea where you're fighting your spirit guide, dude. Secret trap that looks you. That locks you into the room until you kill a mini boss. Cool. Well, doing a thorough job of exploring this world, but I'm just trying to earn 20 more diamonds so I can go craft. Finally test out the crafting, which is hopefully fixed. You're a fan of both 2D and 3D, right? You love 2D more and more? Rooms with a button in them, when pressed, they give you either a reward or a mini boss, bunch of enemies. Yeah, I like that. Yeah, please share that on the Trello if you can. It's a cool idea. All these things, yeah, if you guys have ideas, please share them on the Trello. I'd love to see your ideas and stuff. The only sucky thing about game development is it takes forever to do anything. So, you know, all these great ideas I'd love to do, but it takes time for each one of them. And so I have to get the most important things done first. I gotta prioritize and basically fix bugs over fixing and making the game cooler, at this point at least, while I'm working on this alpha update and all that. I've gotta focus on bugs first, which kind of sucks. I wish I could just, maybe I should focus more on a blend of both, huh? Like maybe do a few bugs each day and a few new features. I don't know, let's see if this is, I can purchase this. I think it was an expensive one. And there were no bombs I could purchase for cheaper here. That sucks. Is there another store? There's another store down there. Let's try that one. I know. New features, new bugs. Yep. That's another part about game development. It's like, dude. I guess I'm just kind of burnt out and complaining. I'm sorry, guys. I shouldn't be complaining so much. I gotta take a really good rest break. Stop coding for a minute. Alright, I guess I could buy more bombs right here. That would refill my bombs, and then hopefully. I hope this works out. Okay, now I'm gonna go use that one secret I found. I think it was two screens to the left. It was here. Wasn't it? Oh, yes! It was right there. Please be a giant cache of diamonds. Yeah, not bad. 85 is not bad, but still not enough to buy. Draw something? Yeah, drawing something is a good thing to do when you're burned out. I should just spend a whole day doing art, huh? I'm so burned out on code and fixing bugs right now. There I go, complaining again. Alright, so I guess I'm looking for the other store. Whoa, damn it. wasting bombs. I do have more of them now. That's good. Yeah, I know. Feature creep, limited time, totally. Yeah, totally change gears. Yep. Need to change gears. Art day, we demand it. All right. What's up, PMC? What's up, Jonah19? What's up, Lime Studios? Yo. Welcome, everybody. I just played through level one of World Seed Annals. And I'm looking for either 80 more diamonds or a different store so I can test out the item crafting, because I need to buy some... I need to buy an element and test out item crafting. So I'm just wandering around the world, trying my luck in different areas. I found one secret that had 85 diamonds. That was a pretty big bonus. Exams are dumb, nice! I can delve into whatever dungeon that is and look for diamonds. You just came back from your exams? You guys got it. It's exams time, huh? Yeah, totally. Mordor Depths of Dejanal. Cool. That's like a sweet name. Level 2. It's good to know where that is. I'm gonna go into it so I mark it as I've been there. In fact, maybe I'll just look for diamonds in here. What's up, Rocket Bunny? Yeah, that's a bug. It's already listed. Gray keys. So this dungeon had gray keys, but it's supposed to have, looks like, red keys. Oh man, I hope opening this door was the right decision. Been 2 hours? Man, I gotta find some diamonds, dude. This is important that I check out the item crafting in this world. I mean, I guess I could just cheat. I mean, I already got a lot of notes already written down. I like being able to see the other area up there. Do you respawn with the courage you had on entry? No. No, you respawn with only three, just like the original Zelda. Otherwise, it would be too easy for people to spam, or I mean, to save, exit, come back, and have their full health again. I'm assuming that's the reason why they designed Zelda 1 the way they did, because that's the way I kept this. Kind of in honor of that, but also kind of for the reason I just stated. Yeah, so the thing is, there's not any health items yet where you can, like, refill your health. But that will be eventually something, so... Like, you'll be able to either hold health in a bottle, like Zelda, or there'll be some kind of, like, fairies or something, you know, like, some kind of item that will refill your health more than just one heart. Also, there's the refills of the overworld. If you go to the refills of the overworld, you can go refill your health there. There's also, yeah, cacti. Cacti give you one health right now, so you can use those to gain back a little bit. And you're invincible for a minute. What's up, Gnome? Yeah, that would be possible, but I just stated the reasons why I don't. I purposely am not saving the game with people's health. First of all, it's an homage to Zelda 1. Second of all, it's too easy. Well, I guess, yeah, if you save with whatever health. There, I got 147 now. Would you guys prefer that? Would you guys prefer that the game saved your health the way that whatever health you had, you saved that? Because, I mean, what if you're down to one health? It would really suck to spawn into your game and only have one health. I mean, I guess you could do minimum health or whatever. I don't know, what do you think? Should it save your health if you're above three? Like, if you have 4 health, and you save your game, you can save at 4 health. Fairy could be a beer can smashed on your head? I like it. I was thinking a flask of whiskey, but a beer can would be the same kind of thing. Whatever, you don't have to... have the health stuff be potions, just don't. Oh, right, yeah, of course it's not gonna be potions. Looking for the witness. Less than a week till the witness? Good, right on. I'm so glad. Both these switch rooms turned out to be kind of relatively easy. I wish I could have fought some different item enemies here, though. I still don't have the money I need, though. You guys like the health as it is, alright. 3 health perfect. Lime, same thing. Yeah, awesome. Yeah, they did change it in later generations, but that's one of the little things that I missed about the very first Zelda. You know, there's a lot of things I missed about the very first Zelda that they never did again, and I have no idea why. To me, Zelda 1 is one of my favorite Zelda games. Yes! 180, I only need 20 more. should at least be like secret rooms too. I got this on my list, is to have more secret rooms where you would just go into the room and all it has is diamonds. These switch rooms is that the annoying freezing wizard doesn't do anything unless you're right next to it. Next to the wizard? Does the right analog do anything? No. No, it's definitely, it's meant to be more of an old school 8-bit or maybe 16-bit game, so that's why there's definitely no dual stickiness going on here. Oh, the blink orb. Wow! That's pretty awesome. Still haven't done the animation for that one. I'm still shy of 20 diamonds! Oh, this world has no diamonds! Neither of these levels have had many diamonds at all. Another reason why the current health system is good, it gives more reason to kill enemies. Yeah. Assuming they drop pickups. To me, it makes action game feel a bit emptier if there's more reason to avoid enemies and to fight them. True, right? That's a good point. So maybe the boss drops some diamonds too? Yeah. Hell yeah. Let's make the bosses, all of them, mini bosses, the regular bosses, drop health and diamonds. Yeah, that's a great idea, because then you're guaranteed. I would have known that going into that dungeon, I would have definitely found, like, you know, like 20 or 30, maybe even up to 50 diamonds or something like that just for beating a boss, you know? That would have been really nice to know. So where, look at that, there's a totally inaccessible screen right there. I wonder if the store is down here. They dropped their lunch money? Oh, yeah. It's Jell-O Boogers. It's so cool playing somewhere and seeing something, thinking, hey, I remember when Wizard Folk coded that? Yeah. I just took out all the touch mouse controls out of Rhythmia because I wanted to make it feel more arcade-like. So it's supposed to be... Oh, cool! What's up, Little Clutch? Thanks, man! If I could find that other store, that would be good. Maybe the south. Oh, no. This is kind of cool. I can warp over stuff now. Even the bombs. One thing about the blink orb right now is this is like level one blink orb, but it's supposed to be shorter. So eventually there'll be three upgrades for the blink orb, or two upgrades. So you have the regular blink orb, which only gets you like one tile in front of it, or you can like only get over one tile. And then there's the second level blink orb where you get over two tiles. Third level blink orb is like this one where you can get over tons of tiles. Basically just do whatever you want. Oh, guaranteed there's an item here. Cactuses also, like I've never seen a cactus drop from an enemy. It's like way too rare. So it's been a good playthrough, lots of little fine, these are tiny adjustments which you wouldn't really consider them bugs, they just like, but they do make a huge difference. Yeah, red one. Alright, I'm gonna start walking this way because I got enough almost. Whoops, keep wasting bombs. I really gotta do these icons for the, or I mean these graphics for the other blink orbs. Mega sparks on rocks, yeah. I've always wanted to make the game more interactive. Like at least so when you hit the bushes and you hit trees, they'll like, you know, shake and release some leaves too. Maybe release an item. Maybe that's how secrets work for trees. You just go and you shake a tree and then all of a sudden it releases some secret. Did I walk onto those? No. Yeah, I walked right behind them, good. It's like, I fixed that, right? Is this the store? God, I'm still seven short! Ugh. A recharge timer for what? What again? Yeah, balancing is a difficult thing because it takes so much time to play and then make these little calls like should I adjust that? Should I not adjust that? Those tiny little decisions do take some time. Maybe these guys. Whenever there's like a thing in the middle of the screen, I just have this feeling that that's more likely to be a reward item. Maybe true. I don't have any cactuses. If I had cactuses, that would really help. But I used them all in the first dungeon. Also, something that you should get more diamonds, more cactuses, more bombs when you're. Oh, I'm so hoping. One. I got freaking one diamond. Yeah, arrhythmia. Man, this game needs more secrets, more items, more bosses, more enemies. He'll get there. I could get to. It looks like when you come from the top. Alright, so yeah, that's that thing with cheese in the last world I played, Dungeon 3. Oh, I'm so tempted if only I could try a bomb here. Oh, I was so hoping for a secret there. No more bombs. So sad. No more bombs. So how as a player would you know that? You shouldn't. You shouldn't know as a player where things are. But like I was saying, I think there's a tendency for the code to place reward items that just pop up in the middle, I'm talking about, in rooms with a blank middle. So that's why I'm thinking that maybe as a developer, like, you know, I can say, okay, this screen just has a blank middle, so maybe there's a good chance that there is a reward item here. But see, there's two in a row where it didn't, so it's, you just never know. I could be wrong about that too. Oh yeah, there is grass for the, or there's wind already for other things. This might as well be wind for grass. Oh my god. It's about freaking time. Alright. Now I gotta go find my way back to the store. Which is... down... downish. Nighttime? I don't know. I'm not sure. There definitely will be items and stuff like that that you can find only at night. There will be mobs that appear only at night. I'm not sure exactly if enemies should be more difficult though at night or whatever. Man, I gotta get going, but I gotta test this one last thing. Can you access Dungeon 3 with the Blink Orb? No, you have to use the cup. Is this it? About time. Okay, so either the fear top hat or the fear blink. If I had bombs, I could see. Maybe the fear top hat. Okay, so if this works, then I'll still have my top hat that I can equip, but I'll also have a fear top hat down here as like an extra item. Oh, you bitch! Forgot that I didn't add the new combos. Please tell me there's a fear blink. Yes! Kind of what I'm missing is different areas have different hard enemies. Huh? Fear blink. Alright. We got the fear blink now. Should be able to transform into... So, what I got? Yep, okay, I used up the fear. I got the fear blink, though. I still have the blink, which is equipable. And if I warp back to Songbringer now, or I mean back to the world, I should still be able to use this fear blink. And I should be able to save my game and look at the data, and it should be correct. Like, I should be able to have the right numbers for my fear blink and all that. Yeah, alright. Cool. It worked! It worked! All that effort just to test one little feature. That was probably a bad use of time to just run around for like half an hour there looking for a couple diamonds. But yeah, I gotta get going, guys. I'm freaking burnt out. I need some rest. Is there a mark return spell? What? There's a, you can warp. You get your teleport. It goes back to where you teleported from. Can you access the fountain now that it's blocked? No, I just noticed what was going on there. It was just that it was from above. That you couldn't get there. So yeah, when you came from the side, the west or the east or the south, it was fine. Please fully read the motor's manual. Oh, that'd be cool. Let me write that down. The jib sticks closer at night. Or maybe jib goes in front of you. I think that would be cool if Jib just went in front of you at night automatically. Yeah, I know they did the crafted conversation. That's a bug too. I don't really care though right now. Like I can't go list another freaking bug. It'll demoralize me. Yeah, later everybody. Like you can mark the map. Yeah, like a bookmark. That's something that was just suggested today on today's stream. I got it on the list, so I'll add that. Yes, go to sleep. I will. Goodbye everybody. Thank you guys. Thank you. Have a good night. Enjoy yourselves.